You cannot build bridges between the wandering islands. The mind has no neighbors, and the unteachable heart announces its amities time after time, but spends its love to draw them closer, closer apart. They are not on the chart. They turn in different shoulders on the island hunters. They are not afraid of Cook or the choirs, nor of the empire builders by missionary bishops and the tourist trade. They are not annexed. They claim no fixed position. They take no pride in the favored latitude. The committee of atolls inspires in them no devotion, and the earthquake belt no special attitude. A refuge only for the shipwrecked sailor. He sits on the shore and sullenly masturbates, dreaming of rescue. The pubs in the ports of call are the big-hipped harlots at the dockyard gates. But the wandering islands drifts on their own business, incurious whether the whales swim in, round, or under, investing no fear in ultimate forgiveness. If they clap together, it's only a casual thunder. And yet they are hurt, for the social polyps never girdle their bare shores with a moral reef. When the iceberg grind them, they know both beauty and terror. They are not exempt from the ordinary grief. And the sudden ravages of love surprises them like acts of God. It's irresistible function. They have never treated the convenient lies as a part of geography or an institution. An instant of fury, a bursting mountain of spray, they rush together, their promontories lock, an instant the castaway hails the castaway, but the sounds perish in that earthquake shock. And then in the crash of ruined cliffs, the smother and swirl of foam, the wandering islands part. But all that one mind ever knows of another, art breaks the long isolation of heart. Was in that instant the shipwrecked sailor's senses, his own despair in the retreating face. Around him he hears in the huge monotonous voice of wave and wind, the rescue will not take place. That was the text of the poem Wandering Island.